This morning in Family Time. April marks Autism Awareness Month, and joining us this morning to talk about this complex developmental disability is Jane Carlson, Vice President of Day and Residential Programs at the Groden Center, along with Lisa Rigo, Groden Center parent and president of the Rhode Island Chapter of Autism Society. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being here, and as you know, I had the pleasure of sitting with Becky and her mom a couple of weeks ago from the Groden Network, and that was just a great story to be able to promote that. And since this month is the Awareness Month, Jane, can you tell us a little bit about Groden Center's work with families to help with autism?
Sure. The Groden Center has been providing services for children with autism for 37 years now here in Rhode Island. We're the oldest service provider specifically dedicated to working with children and families with autism. We have programs that run from early intervention, so children from the time they're first diagnosed, all the way through programs for adults, both in the community and school-based programs.
37 years, it's a long time to be also dedicated to one special thing.
Yes, a very long time.
I'm sure you have events that are happening all the time, too, to kind of get everybody interested and have people come and donate. Are there any that are coming up?
Yes, for Autism Awareness Month, we have several things coming up. Lisa's going to talk about our wine tasting event.
This Thursday, Ooh. We have a wine tasting at the Roger Williams Park Casino. It starts at 6 p.m. Tickets are still available. You can go to the Groden Network website, or you can go to the Autism Society website, which is www.asa-ri.org, and you can buy tickets online. And we just would love people to come out to help us raise awareness of this disability, and a lot of the money that we raise goes to help train first responders in the state, which we've already trained many, to help them learn about autism and how to deal with our individuals if an emergency arises.
Well, it sounds like an excellent event, and I think you mentioned tickets were $40, and like you said, to teach those first responders and the awareness. Is there anything else that you can kind of tell us about early signs of autism?
Yes. The most important thing is that if parents have any suspicion that their child may not be developing typically, they need to talk to their pediatrician right away because early identification is really important to early treatment. So parents might want to look for things like their child not responding when their name is called. If their child isn't seeking them out to share toys with them or not pointing to things and asking them questions, or if they're having a delay in their language development, they should really talk to their pediatrician right away.
Okay, so just to be aware of the surroundings and everything.
Absolutely.
And really quick, I know that you guys have been celebrating National Autism Awareness for 70 years, is that what it is?
Yes.
Or since the 70s, rather.
Mm-hmm.
And what does the funding go to for this treatment?
For all the funds that we raise from our events stay right here in Rhode Island and go to programs for children and their families here in the state of Rhode Island.
Okay, and so it all stays in Rhode Island,
yes.
Which is so good
yes.
to hear.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much, both of you, for being here and talking to us a little bit about it and upcoming events.
Thank
and
you.
If you want to learn more about the Groden Center, check out the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.